This week on Maker Update, putting spam to work, LED filament for your finger, pencil sculpture, and a CNC makeover. Hey everyone, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update, the show where we update you on what makers are making. I hope you're doing well. Let's get started with the project of the week. Spambots by Neil Mendoza is an artwork that combines AI, mechanical keyboards, and 8 cans of spam. Looking at the scene, all these little spam workers are sitting at their little desks, each with their own unique 4-key keyboard. Collectively, there's enough keys here for a complete alphabet and some punctuation, if they all work together. As they type, the screen in front of them is updated with an AI-generated take on Aldous Huxley's Brave New World, modified to include more pork and piggy characters. It's such a great balance of menacing and ridiculous. I also like Neil's choice here going with these small NEMA 17 stepper motors to move the spam arms back and forth. Reflexively, I'd think to use servos here since they're compact and inexpensive, but they're also noisy, which would make a piece like this a symphony of servo gears and sort of take the magic out of it. By going with these relatively quiet stepper motors, you can hear the clacking of the mechanical keys. And even though you can see how it's all working, it's somehow easier to suspend your disbelief when it's quiet like this and all the wires are concealed. I loved it. I'll go as far as to say that this is probably the coolest AI and canned meat project we'll see all year. Prove me wrong. More projects. Charlyn Gonda has a video out on how she made this brass wire LED filament ring. She's shaping the brass using these jeweler's wrapper pliers to get uniform results. Each side is soldered to one end of a coin cell battery holder, which is positioned under the finger. You really have to get the spacing just right for the length of LED filament you have, but the results look super cool. On Instructables, Scott McIndo has a new guide up on how to create a relatively easy replica of George Hart's 72 pencil sculpture using a 3D printed jig. He includes 3 downloadable variations of the jig, one for hexagonal pencils, one for round pencils, and one for crayons. Looks like a fun afternoon project and a great one for kids. Speaking of kids, on Adafruit, John Park shows how he updated this classic Fisher-Price CNC toy with new sounds and images. On the original, there's an assortment of farm animals and animal noises, but John wanted to make a version for city kids with car horns, construction noise, and ice cream trucks. John's guide shows you how to mod the existing toy and integrate an Adafruit KB2040 board, which handles input from the toy and plays back a stored selection of WAV files. John also includes a graphics file by artist Brian Kenzinger, which you can print out or use as a template for making your own custom art. Could be a fun project for making a custom CNC for your own family or a friend with a baby on the way. Now for some tips and tools. On GitHub, Owen McAteer shares some software he developed for controlling and designing Flipdot animations. The application runs within processing and provides visual simulation of the output. So even if you don't have a physical Flipdot display, you can still use this to play around with creating animations. Through Gareth Bramwin's Tips, Tools, and Shoptails newsletter, I came across this reader-submitted idea from Pretty Periwinkle showing how they use a retractable badge holder to keep their soldering iron cable up and out of the way. Through the Core 77 blog, I learned about an Etsy seller who goes by ArtifactDesignNC, who makes these laser-cut wooden shells for die-cast toy cars. It's cool in and of itself, but really it got me thinking about other kinds of purpose-built laser-cut shelves that you could make for stuff. Coin collections, action figures, tiki mugs, whatever you're into, maybe there's an opportunity to make a custom shelf like this, and maybe it's something other people might buy too. While searching Thingiverse for servo holder designs, I found this useful idea from Tokyo Bird. It's a 3D printed holder that fits a basic SG90 type hobby servo and straddles it across your breadboard. How many times have you had to wrangle loose servos like these when you're prototyping a project? This looks like a smart solution. For this week's Digi-Key Spotlight, in honor of Neil Mendoza's Spambot stepper motors, I'm linking to this stepper motor overview video. It gives you a look inside a stepper motor and outlines the benefits and disadvantages to using them in your projects. You also get to see an example breadboard circuit for controlling a stepper motor using an Arduino and a breakout driver board. Check it out. And that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. Big thanks to Digi-Key for making the show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.